Welcome. As brazing and soldering specialists, Lucas-Milhaupt offers comprehensive expertise on brazing procedures. Today we're going to demonstrate brazing copper tubing to fitting assemblies with Lucas-Milhaupt's Sil-Fos. Step one is to clean the tubing and fitting. Parts should be properly cut and reamed to remove burrs. Cleaning should be performed so that the surface contaminants are removed without unwarranted loss of the base metals. Lightly roughen the tube ends and the fitting with wire brushes, steel wool, or fine grades of abrasive papers. Any residual particles in the joint surfaces should be avoided, and any residue remaining after mechanical cleaning must be removed. When joining copper tubing to copper fittings with Lucas-Milhaupt's Sil-Fos brazing filler metal, no flux is required. The phosphorus in the Sil-Fos brazing filler metals gives them a self-fluxing ability when used on copper. However, it is required that a flux be used when brazing other copper alloys, such as brass or bronze. Step two is to insert the tube. Make sure the tubing makes contact with the bottom of the fitting. Support the tube and fitting assembly to provide a consistent gap around the entire circumference of the joint. We're using an oxygen acetylene torch. However, air acetylene with a proper tip or any fuel gas that can rapidly heat copper would also be suitable. A reducing flame is recommended. The flame should be soft enough and large enough to envelop both the tube and the fitting. Step three is to apply heat and the alloy to the braze area. Begin heating with the flame perpendicular to the tube. The copper tube conducts the initial heat into the fitting for even distribution of heat in the joint area. The amount of heating depends upon the size of the joint. Experience will determine the amount of time needed. Next, move the flame onto the fitting. Then, direct the flame from the fitting back onto the tube a distance equal to the depth of the fitting. Begin applying the alloy to the joint to be filled. Do not use the flame to melt the alloy. The alloy should melt due to the heat of the part. Step four is to allow the alloy to be drawn by capillary action to the bottom of the joint. The alloy flows from the outside to the interior by way of capillary attraction. Heat toward the bottom for a second or two to pull the alloy through. The alloy will flow to the area with the highest heat. After brazing, inspect the joint for a uniform fillet around the braze joint. As we've seen, you can braze copper tubing and fitting joints quickly and easily with Lucas-Milhaupt's Sil-Fos products. To review, our steps were 1. Clean the tubing and fitting. 2. Insert the tubing, making contact with the fitting. 3. Uniformly apply heat and the alloy. Then 4. Watch as capillary action draws the alloy and a fillet is formed. For more information, please visit our website or contact your Lucas-Milhaupt representative. Thank you.